Now, when you sign up for Control M trial account, this is how it is going to look like after you log in for the first time. On the left side, you can notice that it is providing you username and password. So this is the username and password which you need to use in order to log into Control M EM. Okay. So this is the icon or single icon which we are going to use. Okay. This is called Control M Workload Automation. So if we double click on this, it is going to be launching and going to ask username and password from us. So we are going to provide this username and password. Again, when it is loading for the first time, it can take some time. So now it has already launched. Let's provide the password, which is going to be EMPass in this case, and click on login. Okay, so again, when user logs in for the first time, it has to load some profile and all. So that's why it can take some time as well. Okay, by the way, Control M Enterprise Manager client is very resource intensive tool, so it is going to consume lots of resources. So just be aware of that. If you are running it on a very, you know, system which is not having much computing power, let's say it is having only 2 GB of RAM and very less computing power, in that case your system is going to be very slow. Okay, so that's how it looks like when you log in for the first time. Now on the left side we have lots of options. So the most important one is planning. Planning is the place where you create all your jobs, you create all the scheduling scenarios. And then under the monitoring, this is the place where you monitor all the jobs. Okay, so let's say you had created 5 jobs, which is supposed to be running every 2 minutes. And now under the monitoring section, you need to go to all active jobs. And this is the place where you are going to see what is the status of all the jobs, whether it is running every 2 minutes or not. Okay, so anything which is related to monitoring and management of jobs, you know, ad hoc management of job, that is going to be taken care in monitoring section. Under the history section, this is very useful, and this is going to give you a way of seeing the history of your jobs. So let's say if you want to see what happened to the jobs which was running on 2 days ago, okay, which was related to, let's say, loading financial statements. So let's say for some reason the job could not load the data and you want to investigate further. In that case, you are going to come to history, and here you are going to search for the jobs, and then you are going to, again, for whichever day you want to see the history, you need to select the history of that day. And then you, if you double click on that, you are going to be presented the option of seeing the jobs which had executed on that particular day. Okay, so this is a place where you manage all the history. I guess by default it loads history of last 10 days, but there is an option of increasing that as well. So let's click on forecast. So forecast is the one which is going to tell you about the future. For example, let's say when you have executed the job to be running on every Sunday, and now you want to see what are the dates on which it is going to be running this year. Okay, so in that case you need to click on forecast, and you will be able to see, okay, if you are running this job to be, or scheduling this job to be running on every Sunday, then it is going to be running on, let's say, 20th and 27th and things like that. Okay, so you'll be able to see all the dates on which it is going to be running on. And here you can also see what if scenario. So let's say you have 10 jobs and let's say job number 5 fails. So in that case, you want to see what is going to happen if job number 5 fails. Will the next set of job will execute, or is there any dependency on this job in order to execute other jobs? So all those sort of things, or predictive analysis, if else analysis, can be done here in the forecast session. Again, since this is a trial environment, you are seeing forecast already enabled. If you are installing Control M, I guess by default forecast is not enabled. You have to install a separate component which is called Control M for forecast. And once you install that component, then only this forecast option is going to be available. And then on the left side, we have this option of tools. Okay, so here you do or manage all of the different Control M components. The most important one is reporting. Okay, so using Control M reports, you will be able to see the execution status of the jobs. So for example, if you want to see what happened to all the jobs which were running yesterday, how much time is taken by each job in order to execute, what time the job was submitted for execution, what time the job was successfully completed, how many total jobs which failed. Okay, so if you want to do those kind of analysis, you are going to use Control M reports. And then the other thing which is here is Control M configuration manager. Okay, so Control-M Configuration Manager is actually available here as a separate icon. So if you click on Control-M Configuration Manager, or let me minimize this, and once we minimize, we can see CCM here. Okay, so CCM is short form of Control-M Configuration Manager. So let's double click on this. And Control-M Configuration Manager is very useful for someone who is actually taking care of Control-M admin stuff. So here also it is going to be asking for password. I'm going to provide the same password which we use for which is defined here. Okay, so let's click on login and see if it works. Okay, so this is working, so which means now it is going to load Control-M Configuration Manager. And in the Control-M Configuration Manager, you see all the agent status, and you are going to have control on starting, stopping, or managing services of Control-M agents. And this is a place where you can also configure alerts, and you can also define users and groups. You can do LDAP integration. Okay, so all your admin related needs, Control-M Configuration Manager is the place. Okay, so as an admin, Control-M admin, you are going to spend a lot of time on Control-M admin console. So just a quick intro, here you can see that there are different control modules installed, and here you can see there are different components which are going to be used for a successful communication between different Control-M components. Okay, now on the top you see we have an option of high availability, and there is option of manage, and then there is an option of security where you can define all the authorization. You can click on manage to, you know, manage host management, and also you can set up exception alerts, you can remove old alerts. So there are lots of things which can be done here. Again, if you want to bring down any component, so you can right click on that, and then you are going to see an option of, you know, you are going to see a different kind of option depending on the, you know, which options you right click on. However, the mainly important thing is that you are going to have an option of bringing any component down, or recycling it, or bringing it up. Okay, so that's the most common scenario of using Control-M Configuration Manager. Again, on the left side here, you can see all the documentation is available. So once you set up the account for free trial, I will request you to just go through all of this documentation, and then it is going to be very easy for you. You are going to be very familiar in terms of using Control-M.